like to join me? How do we get back to Zoom? Now what?
Got it.
Here we are. Hi.
Then you can't remember this is what you did last time. You can't see people's comments. If you want to do that.
How do we do that?
You had Zoom on one screen and your Facebook Live on another. I can pull it up on my phone.
Perfect. We will get our technology straight here in just a second and start our evening prayers. Oh, you know, Kara, we can do it right here on the iPad.
Yeah, but remember then you had two cameras going last time?
That's because I had Zoom on both of them. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Carrie Jo Harvey can see us and hear us. Oh, wait. But the flaw is I had my music right there.
Yeah, so let me just do what I said.
Welcome to our marriage. Then I want to share. That. Image. Okay. For now, we are ready. So, hey, everyone. We're going to sing two hymns tonight, Seek Ye First and the Old Rugged Cross, and do use the same devotional that we used on Tuesday night. So I'm going to lead us through a verse of Seek Ye First, and then Kara will lead us through the psalm and through this text from Romans. And then we'll sing the next verse and then do some reflection.
Psalm is Psalm 27. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? Do not hide your face from me. Do not turn your servant away in anger. You have been my helper. Do not reject me or forsake me, God, my Savior. Though my father and mother forsake me, the Lord will receive me. Teach me your way, Lord. Lead me in a straight path because of my oppressors. Do not turn me over to the desires of my foes, for false witnesses rise up against me, spouting malicious accusations. I remain confident of this. I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord.
Ask and it shall be done.
Read reading from Romans chapter 6, verses 8 through 14. Now, if we died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. For we know that since Christ was raised from the dead, he cannot die again. Death no longer has mastery over him. The death he died to sin once for all, but the life he lives to God. In the same way, count yourselves dead to sin, but alive to God in Christ Jesus. Therefore, do not let sin reign in your mortal body so that you obey its evil desires. Do not offer any part of yourself to sin as an instrument of wickedness, but rather offer yourselves to God as those who have been brought from death to life, and offer every part of yourself to him as an instrument of righteousness. For sin shall no longer be your master, because you are not under the law, but under grace. So I'll read this again, and I'd invite you to share any words or ideas that are stirred within you that bring, that your attention is brought to, something about the reading that you'd like to ask God about or to pray about. Now, if we died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. For we know that since Christ was raised from the dead, he cannot die again. Death no longer has mastery over him. The death he died to sin once for all, but the life he lives to God. In the same way, count yourselves dead to sin, but alive to God in Christ Jesus. Therefore, do not let sin reign in your mortal body so that you obey its evil desires. Do not offer any part of yourself to sin as an instrument of wickedness, but rather offer yourselves to God as those who have been brought from death to life, and offer every part of yourself to him as an instrument of righteousness. For sin shall no longer be your master, because you are not under the law, but under grace. So what words, phrases, ideas stirred within you? Excuse me. Under grace. Not under law, but under grace. Grace. No mastery.
I don't want to share it yet. Hold on. So we're going to move into a time of prayer. And this devotional invites us to pray for spiritual renewal in this season of Lent, for deep heart repentance and a genuine humility born of the gospel, for new relationships with non-Christians, it's also a space for us to pray for whatever's on our hearts right now. So I invite you in the comment section to list your prayers, and we can read those out loud, and Kara will read those, and I can say, God in your mercy, and then all of us together will respond, hear our prayer.
I'd lift up, I shared on our page today that some of you knew Krista Goble, who worshiped with us for a time, and she, I got word today that she passed yesterday of cardiac failure. So prayers for her family and the many, many lives that she touched.
God, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
We lift up Marlene Vorenkamp. She went home today. She's in her home, and Marlene's daughters are caring for her, along with hospice, who is providing just comfort care. Marlene can hear and respond, and she can speak, but with labored, muffled words. But I did have the great occasion to FaceTime with her. So they've got her an iPad, and who thought Marlene would ever have her own FaceTime account? And we had a good time together. So they welcome those phone calls, but of course, no visitors. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayers. Prayers for Jean Borner, who is currently in the ER.
Oh, God, in your mercy,
hear our prayers. Prayers for those in the hospitals, all of them, caregivers and patients, and those in the community seeking to provide care to others, like our own Tracy. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Prayers for a happy birthday for Matt. God, in our gratitude,
hear our prayers. Keep going. I'm just
for those who are feeling alone during this time of isolation. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For Andrea, for her kids who are missing their people tonight and who are afraid. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For gratitude for Sunnyside and the people of Sunnyside. God, in our gratitude,
hear our prayers. Sing a verse of the Old Rugged Cross. You can certainly continue to list your prayers as we do. On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame.
Oh,
the dearest and best. For a world of us sinners are saved. So I'll cherish the old rugged road till my trophies that last time I will cling to the old rugged road and exchange a Sunday for a crown. If I can remember how to do this. So I invite you into this prayer with me. You can read along out loud or to yourself. Surprising God, who would have thought that dying was good? My instinct is to avoid it. But in Jesus, I see that dying is the way to life. Equip me to do it is so difficult, to die to myself and to become new. May I be genuinely sorry for my sin, to hate it more and more, and to run away from it. Amen. Offer this word of blessing in just a moment, but first I want to remind you that Sunday morning we're going to have worship together at 11. That's a half an hour later than last week. Our sleep, everything, sleep schedule is completely wanky and out the door now. So I suspect everybody's is. I don't understand. Apparently I said something wrong. I should go to bed earlier. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. Good night, friends.
Good night.
I don't know how to stop.